Hey guys, we're back. We're doing a 420 Bible study and Torah tour. We're fingering our way through the Bible. And at that point, we are in 1 Peter 4. We're just finishing it up. We'll do an offering to say thank you to God for creating the branch, which then turned out to be his only branch. Well, he had two sons. They're separated, light and dark, lighter and darker, light air and dark air, old air, old bread, new air, new bread, falling bread, rising bread. I guess the first batch didn't work out too well.
Smoking herb and drinking burning liquor. Never rich, so we were out to make that steady bigger.
Now we can thank God for smoking this burning liquor, right? So let's read through 1 Peter. Dear friends, do not be surprised at the fiery ordeal that has come on you to test you, fiery test, as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice with the oil inasmuch as you participate in the sufferings of Christ. I can't believe the earth is like this. It really is like this. That's why Jesus said when he's on the cross, Father, they don't know what they're doing, because it's just an internal awareness, the awakening. So, if you are insulted because of the name of Christ, you are blessed, which would be Jacob's blessing. So you have the aroma and the manna, and you have, I don't know, we've eaten his flesh and drank in his blood because he's the righteous branch, the aroma. For the spirit of glory and of God rests on you, which is quite cool. Kind of strange, daily reminders, it sinks in, and then you're like, what? Really? I have all the, don't take it away. It's a dream. It can't be true. It's almost too good to be true. It's true. But slowly but surely, each one of you, as you practice and you practice and you read and you join the new team, it'll come to you. He'll send you positive energy and positive thoughts. So if you suffer, it should not be as a murderer or a thief or any other kind of criminal, or even as a meddler. So don't do wrong. However, if you suffer as a good Samaritan, it says Christian, I'm going to say a good Samaritan. A good Samaritan offers their God the aroma to get into the afterlife, in hope that we get in. Do not be ashamed, but praise God that you bear that name. Okay? It says Christian. We're going to redefine this Christian sect. It's a man of God, Emmanuel. For it is time for judgment to begin with God's household. And if it begins with us, the Jews, what will be the outcome for those who do not obey the gospel of God? And that's what Moses said. Hey, guys, if you're not going to listen to me, sons of Korah, versus the Torah, when I'm here, what are you going to do when I'm gone, Moses said. At that point, Moses is back. He's right inside me. He hangs out with me all the time. Now, I'm saying the same thing that Moses said, without caution, I mean, without fear. It says, because it says it right here. It's time for judgment. It's time to repent, for the kingdom of God is near. Yes, repent in sackcloth and ashes and offer up the aroma. Now we know how to repent. So it is time for judgment to begin with God's household. And if it begins with us, Jews, here's the great question. What will be the outcome for those who do not obey the gospel of God? And it is, and we're just going to finish out the tour with a little bit extended version. Here's the quote. If it is hard for the righteous to be saved that have the branch and don't put it down and say, oh, I'm just going to become a Christian, which is what people have done. They say the branch is wrong. And I'm like, oh my goodness, no, the branch is the awakening. That's why everybody's still searching. So if it says, and I think it is 18, this is Proverbs 11:31. We'll do a flip on it. If it is hard for the righteous to be saved, what will become of the ungodly and the sinner? So no joke, there's two lines, and it's hard to get into this line. But once you're in, it's like, oh my goodness, what's going to happen to this line? And then I go back, and I'm like, no, don't do that. Please stop the wrath. And guys, turn and offer, and everybody just start praising the one and only God, which is exactly what Jesus says, which is exactly what Paul says, which is exactly what this book says. There's only one God, and he's jealous, angry, but if you want to stop the wrath and anger, you're going to offer him the aroma that's satisfying, pleasing, and it reminds him of his son, Jesus. And when Jesus says, do this in memory of me, he's talking about lighting up. He's getting high. That's why he was so ostracized at that point. To summarize 1 Peter 4. So then, those who suffer according to God's will should commit themselves to their faithful Creator and continue to do good. Say that again. So then, those who suffer according to God's will should commit themselves to their faithful Creator and continue to do good. Which is really strange is that if it's God's will and He's our Father and we get the inheritance when our Father dies, well, God's not going to die. It's the voice. At that point, we're going to die first. So how do we get the inheritance if we die first? Interesting. Maybe we should abide by the will of God, the written will, figure out what it says and abide by it, offer, and then when we die, he'll say, hey, you abided by my will, good and faithful servant. Thanks for serving me all the days of your life. Now let me serve you with the aroma of heaven. Baruch Hashem and God bless.